Welcome to our meeting. Thank you for attending. I'm going to speak to you about MRS. As Fabio mentioned, MRS is used for scheduling your resources and matching with the demands that you have. What I'll do, I'll show you first where the demand comes from. Then I'll show you where the resources come from. Afterwards, I'll show you the MRS planning board, which is where you do most of the work. And then I'll show you some features within the planning board. For this example, we will use a project, but you're not limited to projects. You could do, you could get work orders from plant maintenance. You could also get customer service orders from your CRM and have them in the same screen, or you could divide them. You could have the planning board only show one at a time. So here we have a project. If you're not familiar with SAP projects, it's okay. We could talk to you and show you afterwards. Here we just have a simple project, a pump installation. These are the different activities. We're gonna focus on what data you need from your project that's important to have. First thing you need is your work center, which is right here. I'll explain to you what a work center is. A work center is basically a shop or department. It is, for example, let's say you have a group of electricians. You put them all in your electrician's work center. Let's say you have five of them, you put that and you put their schedule and all that. And then when somebody needs some electrical work done, they'll just put here in the activity, oh, I need a work center electricians. Now, on top of that, you could also put qualifications they need for a specific activity. This being a prepare RFQ, you have very specific qualifications. If we click here, you'll see that this particular activity requires somebody speaks English at a good level, very good project management skills, and then has adequate knowledge of CAD. Now, as a PS, now I'm going to show you the resources, where they come from. Here's resources. So this comes from HR, but you don't have to have HR all the time. You could assign your resources as partners, and then you could import them over to MRS. But in this example, I used HR. So here in HR, we have something that we create. It's called an organizational unit, org unit. Here you have at the very top every project services. From there we have different, structured differently. We have a department head, helder. Then we have project managers. We have here by positions. We have consultants, electricians, mechanics, controller. If you look at the senior project manager, we have Oprah Winfrey. If we look at electricians, we have Brad Pitt, David Beckham, and mechanics, we have a few other guys. So now the way MRS works is that you have to make all this master data in SAP R3. Then you transfer it to MRS. You only have to do it once, and then there'll be a link between the two. Now we're gonna go to the planning board. Here's the planning board already pulled up. You'll see here are all the resources that we have from the org unit. Helder, Paul, Fabio, Oprah. Here's all the resources. Next thing you'll notice is their available hours for the week. They're hard workers, so they're available more than 40 hours a week. And then you see the utilization. Right now, Oprah Winfrey has 21% utilization because of 10 hours of her time have been used up. Paul, the same. Thor here has 17% usage. Now, you could customize this. You could put different columns, but this is just an example. And here you have your Gantt chart. Here's you can make it tabular, or you can make it Gantt, or you can just drag and drop into the different places and it shows the hours. You could increase, make it closer, make it further away, up to you. Whatever works best for you. And then here you have your demand. You'll see that this is also the way information you see here is configurable. Here you have the status of your operations, your activities. Here you have the network number. Here you have the different activities for within that network, the number of resources, and the duration this should last. So now I'm going to start using it, you know, just doing a little planning, pretend I'm your planner. So we'll start off with a very easy one. I'm just going to take this activity right here. I'm going to drag and drop it to Paul for Wednesday. Here you go. Very easy. You could assign it to an individual person like Paul. Like I said, you could have different resources. You could have equipment. You could have tools and that come up, and they'll be over here as well. You could also assign the same operation to a tool and equipment and book its time. And you could even have different time allocation here. So this is his schedule 8 to 4, but maybe the tools are available 24 hours. On top of that, what you could do, you could also lengthen the operation, the activity here. I could say, okay, well, it's really, I'm gonna have it from 8 to 4. Paul's busy doing some things in between, just as long as he finishes by the end of the day. Another thing you could have is, you could have a thing called a concrete and capacitive. So here we made the operations actually gonna take longer now to do. But what we could have done instead, we could have taken an opera. I'll give you an example. I'll take here, procurement's also 3 hours. I'll assign it to Paul right here. You see it goes on for 3 hours. But what I could do, instead of making it concrete means it needs to be done between this time to this time, 8 to 11, no flexibility. And then capacitive means, look, just finish it by end of day Friday. So here I'm gonna put it into the capacitive. And you'll see that it can be started from beginning of the week till now. So that's an example of capacitive. So now you see the status has changed. They're both green now, means they've been planned. Now, a few other things you could do. You could take a, we're gonna take a longer operation here. So here we're gonna take the commissioning is 16 hours, pretty big. So we're gonna give it to Albert Einstein. And then what we're gonna do, we're gonna take the same operation right here today, because we need to do some of it today. And we're gonna split it. So you just right click, you split. Once you split the assignment, you could take the next one, see here, I highlight it. And now I'm gonna give it to Brad Pitt to do along with Angela. So here you go. Sometimes you have operations that require special qualifications. For example, here we have prepare RFQ. As you notice when we looked at the project, that it needed a qualified project manager. In MRS, it allows you to find people quite quickly. You just highlight the demand, click here, suitable resources. It will tell you who are the suitable resources. So right now, Oprah has 100 across all items, except for availability, but this is a very important task to prepare the RFQ, so we'll make her available. Also, we'll say that since she's so qualified, it only takes 8 hours. So we'll create the assignment right from here. It'll assign it to Oprah automatically. Here it is. Drag it to Wednesday. Perfect. Next, we're gonna show now, in case your employees are sick, absent. So let's say Brad Pitt is not feeling well for the rest of the day. So you just highlight here, show that Brad Pitt's away for the rest of the day. And then you put a illness. He's only absent 4 days. He's sick. He'll be hopefully back tomorrow. Okay, we have that there. Next, sometimes you need to do that for a group of people. How do you do that for a group of people very quickly? Well, here we're going to have a few people who are going away on a going to the IT gala today. So what we do, we highlight the time. We'll say Oprah's going to be there. And then we add a few more people. So I'll say also Nelson Mandela and Fabio. Close it, create, actually put absence, IT gala. There, shows that they're absent. Yeah. Show you a couple more things. Now you guys are experts at the resource planning board. I'll show you now the what the demand planning board looks like. Just press that button, it switches very quickly. Here we'll see the different colors Fabio spoke about. So red means untouched, nobody's planned anything, we haven't done anything about these figures yet. Green means it's finished, and blue means it's been started. So you can configure it as colors, you can put any colors you feel are suitable for your needs in different situations. Now go back to the here. Last but not least, I'll show you the utilization report. You go to utilization report, you click, select your group. Here we go, we see that we have some assigned orders, we have some unassigned orders, and here we have a lot of work orders that need to be done. But Wednesday and Thursday, we've kind of matched it up. You could have all sorts of reports, pretty dynamic, just one example. But I hope you got a little bit of a glimpse, enough of a glimpse that you are now curious. And we have a half hour before the next presentation. If you wish to sit here and see some more features, please let Fabio and I know. And have a great day. Thank you for coming. Yeah.